In February, Helicopter Association International held its annual Heli-Expo at the Dallas Convention Center. Over a million square feet of exhibit space was filled with helicopter manufacturers and suppliers. This annual event is often a time where the newest aircraft are put on display. That was certainly the case for Texas-based Bell Helicopter, which introduced its Bell 525. Other manufacturers rolled out their latest models, like Augusta Westland, Marenco, EuroCopter, and Metro Aviation, just to name a few. Add-on accessories and suppliers were also on display, like camera systems from L3, Dart Helicopter Services, and various simulators. Since we have a special connection to Sikorsky, Live Air Show TV's military liaison and field producer CW2 Brian Lee is currently flying a UH-60 Blackhawk. We had to find out more about what they had going on. In addition to their new aircraft on display, we talked to Christy Fleischman about their Legacy of Heroes program.
Legacy of Heroes is an S-92 tour that Sikorsky is doing to recognize and celebrate first responders and heroes all over the world, from fire and rescue workers to military pilots to emergency medical services.
We also spoke with one of the tour's pilots, Melissa Mathiason.
The Legacy Tour started in October of 2011, and it was an inspiration to honor the legacy of Igor Sikorsky, who invented the helicopter to save lives. So in October 2011, we started a world tour. It started in the United States, and we are going around the world honoring heroes, first responders, and militaries who work together to save lives and enhance humanitarian relief around the world.
The tour is in Asia during the first part of 2012. Go to the link section of our website for more info on Sikorsky and the Legacy of Heroes tour. Like so many of the events we cover, in addition to new aircraft, Heli-Expo pays tribute to the past with their heritage of helicopters display. Without a doubt, the most popular display was the Russian Hind Mi-24 gunship. It is owned and flown by the Cold War Museum in Lancaster, Texas. We will have more on the Mi-24 in a future story. The main reason we made the trip to Dallas was to catch up with the crew of the 25th Infantry Huey helicopter. You will recall their heroic efforts at the 2011 Reno Air Races when they jumped into action following the crash of the Galloping Ghost. The Huey was on display as part of the National Aviation Heritage Invitational, and within minutes, the aircraft was prepped and fueled and was flying the injured to a Reno hospital. We asked Chief Pilot Ray Murphy what stands out to him several months later.
The team took the Huey from static display to let's go fly mode in very short order, and that was a challenge.
Does he have any regrets?
Not really, but I was disappointed when we came back and says, okay, here we are, we're ready again. And they said, no assistance necessary. When there's an aircraft accident, they close the airport, period. So that may have been one thing.
Co-owner Chris Miller says that the fact that this very aircraft once again performed the same mission it was tasked with in Vietnam is not lost on the crew or those who see it.
You get such heartfelt stories about, you know, that's what that ship was all about. It was all about bringing people back to safety, you know, and getting them to the medical help so that they could live. It was an aircraft that saved lives, that brought their brothers back from battle safely.
The crew surprised us by bringing along the original crew chief that flew with Ray in Vietnam, Gonzalo Salazar. Poncho, as he was known, couldn't say enough about flying with Ray.
If I had to go to battle today at the age of 65, he would be one of the top pilots that I would love to fly with again.
It was very special for him to fly with the crew to Reno last September.
Ray was one that called me, and he said, are you Poncho? I said, yes, I am. He said, well, he says, I've got a surprise for you. He says, I've got 961. I said, you kidding? He said, well, I don't have it, but I fly it. and they would love for you to come by this coming summer and be a part of the crew that flies it to Reno, Nevada, and help the Afghanistan vets with one more helicopter ride.
And when he found out what the crew did?
But I didn't know that it was 961 that medevaced quite a few people out of there. And to my amazement, I said to myself, she's still saving lives.
For their efforts, the crew was awarded the EuroCopter Golden Hour Award at the banquet that evening. Afterwards, co-owners Mike House and Chris Miller were all smiles.
I feel a little bit embarrassed that we were even invited to this. I appreciate the sentiment, though. Once we got here, I felt that I'm honored that we were selected. And I want to thank all of you for supporting us. And thank you for everything you've done with us. Thank you.
Watch for the 25th Infantry Huey at an air show this season. They have over 30 events planned. It was great to catch up with them and be there when they were recognized by the helicopter industry. We cannot thank them enough for stepping up in a time of need and letting that chopper perform its mission one more time. From the 2012 Heli-Expo in Dallas, Texas, I'm Jeff Lee, Live Air Show TV.